I've noticed people, especially people new to goats, they don't know what to expect in the milk pail. And they're very happy with a quart, you know, at each milking. And that'd be great if you had Nigerian dwarfs. That would be a really good production. But on a full-size doe, like an Alpine or a Saanen or a Toggenburg, that's not a lot of milk. And you shouldn't be happy with that kind of milk. There's two things that go into how much milk a doe will produce. Genetics and what you feed them. And 9 times out of 10, when people aren't getting very much milk, they aren't feeding adequately or they aren't feeding the right things. You have to, if you want top production, you gotta feed for it. And yeah, that's not cheap. But I think most people have dairy animals because they want the quality of the product, and they aren't really looking to get cheap milk. They're looking to get good milk and milk that they can trust feeding their families. But of course, who knows with the drought conditions and what feed prices are going to be, who knows if we may be getting cheap milk and good milk eventually. I don't know, especially if you can produce your own feed. But this is what I feed. I feed Purina goat chow. I was buying our mix from the feed mill that they do custom, but my goats seem to like this better, and I've noticed my milk production does increase with this. So Purina goat chow, I know it's probably got GMOs in it, and I know, guys, you do the best you can with what you have to work with. My feed mill makes a natural pig feed without GMOs, and it makes a natural chicken feed without GMOs. They don't make a natural goat feed, so I might as well buy the commercial stuff until I can find a non-GMO mix that my goats will produce well on and like. So I feed this. She only gets grain once a day because she's only being milked once a day. If she was being milked twice a day, she would get twice the amount of grain. No, she's not going to eat all this. I just fill it up, and for as long as she's up there, she gets to eat it. Or if she starts getting bored and starts pawing, and then she's done. She will not finish this whole thing. Also to that, I add the red pellets here. Yeah, you're going to get it in a minute. The red pellets here are calf manna. This is a supplement. It's multi-species. It's really good for animals in production, sick animals that you're trying to bring back, babies that are weaned that you don't want to go downhill, old animals that you have trouble keeping weight on. You can feed it to just about anything. It's been around forever. It's called calf manna, and it's great stuff. And then those are sunflower seeds. That just adds a little fat to their diet. You can also feed, I'm out right now, but you can also feed a little brewer's yeast with the good, I think it's B vitamins that those have in it. That's just a little top dressing sprinkles that you can add. So that's what I feed. And also, let's go look at hay. Okay, here are the two kinds of hay that I have right now. This is my horse hay. This is just a soft grass mix. It might have a little timothy in it here and there, but a very, I won't say low quality hay, but more of a roughage type hay. Probably much lower protein than what I feed my goats, which is over here. And this is an alfalfa soft grass mix. I don't know if you can pick up the alfalfa, but there's a clump of it. There's some. It's just mixed throughout the bale. It's probably about 33% alfalfa. And what you want is a higher protein hay for your goats. I wouldn't go over 50% protein though, because you don't want to get it too rich. That's hard on their kidneys. The best kind of hay you can find for goats is what you should be buying. And if you can find a clover alfalfa grass mix, that would be wonderful. Now you can feed something like this for horses. It's much cheaper, and a lot of people do. But don't expect to see optimal results in your milk pail, because you won't. I definitely notice if I run out of my goat hay and I have to substitute some horse hay, I definitely notice a drop in production. You know, you have to give them the tools to make the milk, so to speak, or to make a lot of milk if that's what you're after. And I know people don't like to spend the higher dollar for this good quality hay, but the first thing you need to do is make yourself a no-waste goat feeder. And there's different models out there. I put up a video of one that we came up with that's working beautifully. And so if you don't have any ideas how to do that, go, oh boy, maybe 6 months ago and check out the No Waste Goat Feeder video that I put up. Real easy, inexpensive to make, and it works like a charm. Some people have good luck with keyhole feeders, that they take a 55-gallon drum or whatever, and they cut a keyhole in it, and so I didn't have good luck with that. I've tried different mangers, I've tried hay bags, but what we came up with our current feeder is working really well. So once you get something like that, you're not going to feel as bad buying the expensive bale of hay, because the goats don't waste it. And that's really, I know, maddening when you see all your dollars in the bedding. I'm not going to tell you what I pay for hay, because that's really a region by region thing, so it's really not probably going to be relevant in your neck of the woods. And this year, every year is different, but do try to find the best quality hay you can, with at least some legumes in it. And we have alfalfa. I know down south there's peanut hay and whatnot, clovers, whatever. At least 50%, or I should say, up to 50%, and that should be a really good hay. And you also, you know, just like any hay, you want it dry. You don't want any mold or what they call dust. If you part, you know, your flakes and this little cloud of dust comes up, you've got moldy hay, and that shouldn't be fed to goats or horses or probably any animal. People say, oh, goats are have the chambered stomachs, they are ruminants, so they can handle it. But no, you don't want to mess with their rumens, and mold can be toxic. So yeah, don't feed that to your goats, despite what people tell you. Okay, that's my little thing on hay and food and milking continuously, and hopefully that's helpful for your home dairy.